Having understood about the hydraulic gem, formation of the hydraulic gem, working on some problems on finding the total length of the apron and the downstream foot of the spillway, which would be the sum total of the length of the gradually varied flow and the length of the rapidly varied flow, and the total loss of energy would be equal to the loss of energy, sum of the loss of energy in rapidly varied flow and the gradually varied flow. Let us try to look at some of the basic characteristics of the hydraulic gem. Loss of energy in the hydraulic gem, just now we have seen, it is given by the expression y2 minus y1 whole cube by 4y1 y2. y2 minus y1 whole cube by 4y1 y2. What are y1 and y2? They are the initial and sequent depths. Depth of flow before the jump, depth of flow after the jump. So the ratio delta E by E1 is called the relative loss. Delta E is the difference of these two specific energy values, E1 minus E2. Loss of energy delta E divided by E1 is called the relative loss. Efficiency of the jump is ratio of specific energy after the jump to the before jump. It's called the efficiency. Specific energy after the jump to the specific energy before the jump is called the efficiency of the hydraulic jump. This is also given in terms of the Froude's number, initial Froude's number, as 8 FR1 square plus 1 whole to the power 3 by 2 minus 4 FR1 square plus 1 divided by 8 FR1 square into 2 plus FR1 square. So this equation indicates that the efficiency of a jump is a dimensionless function depending only on the Froude's number of the approaching flow. It depends only on FR1, nothing more. It depends only on FR1, and it is called E2 by E1 is called the efficiency of the jump. The relative loss also can be expressed to be delta E by E1 or 1 minus E2 by E1. 1 minus E2 by E1. What is the height of jump? What do you mean by this height of jump? Height is that, no, at the foot of the spillway, you have a depth of y1. Immediately in the subsequent portion, you have a depth of y2. So the difference of these two depths is called the height of the hydraulic jump. So the difference between the depths after and before the jump is called the height of the jump. Hj would be equal to y2 minus y1. So to make this dimension less, Hj by e1 will be equal to y2 by e2 minus y1 by e1. So Hj by e1 is called the relative height, and y1 by e1 is the relative initial depth, and y2 by e1 is called the relative sequent depth. In the dimensionless form, Hg by e1 may be expressed in terms of the initial Froude number FR1 also. To classify these jumps based on the Froude's number, hydraulic jumps are classified. Basically, it is a rapidly varied flow, which may be occurring because of the change in slope of the bed of the channel, or there may be at the downstream foot of the spillway, if this may be occurring. So these jumps are classified depending on the initial Froude number. If the value of the Froude number, initial Froude number FR1 is equal to 1, the flow is critical. There is no formation of hydraulic jump at all. Hydraulic jump forms only in rapidly varied flows, where the flow must be supercritical first. Initially, it must be supercritical. That means the value of the Froude number must be more than 1. Then only there will be formation of the hydraulic jump. So if the value of the Froude number is between 1 to 1.7, the jump so far formed is called undular jump. The water surface shows undulations, and the depth, the sequent depth ratio delta E by E1 is very small. Practically, this would be zero. Delta E by E1 value would be zero. Undular depth, not much of loss of energy takes place. You can see here, small undulations may be there. And the change in depth of flow in both the things is also very small. So you have the Froude number. From about 1 to 1.7. This is called undular jump. Weak jump may be formed if the value of the Froude number is between 1.7 to 2.5. So you have a sluice gate opening. So at the downstream portion, there may be formation of the jump like this. Initial depth y1, sequent depth y2. A small loss of energy also would be taking place here. So dissipation of energy with the Froude number from 1.5 to 2.5. So the very less energy dissipation, maybe about 5% to about 18%. At initial Froude number of 1.7, you have about 5%. At 2.5 Froude number, you have about 18% loss of dissipation of energy takes place. So smooth water surface after the jump will be there. The fourth classification is oscillating jump. The Froude number between 2.5 to 4.5. So this category of jump is characterized by an instability of the high velocity flow in the jump, which oscillates in a random manner between the bed and the surface. So there may be about 2.5 to 4.5%. So the dissipation of energy may be about 18 to 45%. Next is a steady jump between 4.5 to 9 Froude number, and the loss of energy, the dissipation may be about 45% to 70%. So foot of the spillway, maybe from 45% to 70% is a steady jump. Then strong jump, when the Froude number is more than 9 and the energy loss will be more than 70%. Rough water surface may be there. So downstream water surface is also very, very rough. Then it is called strong jump. Okay. So this is about the classification of the hydraulic jump. A small problem related to the hydraulic jumps, hydraulic sequence depths is given here, like Y1, Y2, and the relation of Y1 and Y2 in terms of the Froude number. This could be a derivation or even a problem also. Show that the relationship between the initial and the sequence depths of a hydraulic jump on a horizontal floor in a rectangular channel. See what conditions are given. It is considered to be a horizontal floor and it is a rectangular channel, and you need to find the relationship between Y1 and Y2 with Froude number FR1. So to have the convenience, FR, instead of writing FR1, it is written F1, it doesn't matter. Y2 by Y1 whole square plus Y2 by Y1 minus 2 F1 square is equal to 0. F1, the Froude's number of the approaching flow, that means initial Froude number. Y1 and Y2, the initial and sequence depths respectively. Okay, so you consider the formation of the hydraulic jump, Y1, V1, Y2, V2, the depth and velocity at section 1 and section 2, before and after the jumps. Applying the momentum equation, P1 minus P2 minus the component of the self-weight minus the frictional resistance would be equal to the rate of change of momentum. So substituting that, Q square by GA1 plus A1Z1 bar is equal to Q square by GA2 plus A2Z2 bar. For a rectangular channel, you have the values Q, A into V, so BY1 into V1, which is also equal to BY2 into V2. Similarly, Z1 bar, depth of centroid, Y1 by 2. Z2 bar, depth of centroid at section 2, Y2 by 2. Y1 by 2, Y2 by 2. Small Q, the distance per unit with capital Q by B. Substituting all these values here, you will be getting Q square by G into BY1 plus Q square by plus BY1 into Y1 by 2 is equal to Q square by G into BY2 plus BY2 into Y2 by 2. Q square by GB, if you take out common from first term of left hand side, first term of second right hand side. So Q square by GB into 1 by Y1 minus 1 by Y2 is equal to half of B into Y2 square minus Y1 square. Or 2 Q square by GB into Y2 minus Y1 by Y1 Y2 is equal to Y2 plus Y1 into Y2 minus Y1. So same equation, what we have derived for the governing equation relating to the rectangular channels. Okay, small Q is equal to capital Q by B. Only thing is, you have to now convert this equation into the required form in terms of the Froude number. So you have Y2 minus Y1 here, you have Y2 minus Y1 gets cancelled on both the sides. So you have 2 Q square by G is equal to Y1 Y2 into Y1 plus Y2. Or Y1 square Y2 plus Y1 square Y1 Y2 square is equal to 2 Q square by G. Now, what you need to do is divide with Y1 cube, both left hand side and right hand side. divide with y1 cube, dividing with y1 cube on both the sides, you will be getting y1 square y2 by y1 cube plus y1 y2 square by y1 cube is equal to 2q square by g y1 cube. Now you have got here in the first term y1 square, and in the denominator y1 square gets cancelled. So you have y2 by y1 plus y2 by y1 whole square is equal to 2q square by g y1 cube. What is this q square by g y1 cube? It is something connected with the Froude number. Froude number f r is equal to v by root g d, or d hydraulic depth is equal to a by t. Substituting that a by t here, a is b into y by the top width will be equal to the bed width for the rectangular channel, and hence t is equal to b. B b gets cancelled. Hydraulic depth d is equal to y. Hydraulic depth d is equal to y. So substituting here, the Froude number f r would be equal to v by square root of g into y, or q by y into square root of g y. So taking y inside, you have f r square would be equal to q square by g y1 cube. Q square by g y1 cube, this is the term that you have got. Q square by g y1 cube may be replaced by f r1 square, and hence you have y2 by y1 whole square plus y2 by y1 minus 2 f r1 square would be equal to 0. This is what is required as per the problem, and we have obtained the same thing. Okay, we stop.